We've been looking at modern materials in the past few classes. What are these modern materials? Materials which we are using our engineering skills and knowledge of science, whatever we are applying, all of this is becoming into a material which we which follows what we want. Okay, we are strengthening materials on the microscopic scale. Okay, sometimes a little more on the macroscopic scale. We are adding some fibers to give some strength. Okay, and then there are other things like polymerization also, which we do to some materials to get a strength which we require. Sometimes we use radiation like heat or even X-ray to get the property that we require. Okay, so it depends what we are doing with the material depends on our knowledge of materials and also what we do. But as civil engineers, what we are more interested is how a particular material can be used for a particular application. So this is what we are more concerned about. Okay. Now, today we are going to have a look at glass. And in the last class in particular, we are looking at some of the mathematical models of how we can find out whether a material is strong enough. How we analyze a composite material, we use some assumptions. We create some assumptions. We generate some assumptions so that we are able to get the constitutive relationship. Okay. So again, we saw what is stress, what is strain, okay, and various moduli. And beside this, we saw the various types of failure modes and some other definitions of material strength or how we compare one material with another. So I am going to start with a very with a short video that shows how glass has been used. It's an old video, but still I think it's relevant. So these are some of the ways or places where glass is being used. So fundamentally, as civil engineers, you are very much bothered about how this glass is going to be placed in position and how you seal the space between the glasses and how you can ensure that it is going to perform under adverse conditions. Okay, adverse conditions are a lot of heat in terms of sunlight, and then there is also rain and wind. So there's a huge combination, okay, of there's a combination of forces or factors that affect the glass. So what we are very much bothered is we are going to ensure that the glass when placed is going to perform satisfactorily. This is the this is what civil engineers are very much concerned. And all these architectural shapes mostly are given to us by architects. So an architect will give you the form, the structural engineer in you will be designing the supporting systems, and then you will be having the how you are going to place it, okay, how you are going to place it inside is the work which most of you will be doing in practice. So what is glass? Glass is a super cool liquid, and it is not having any fixed crystal structure. Glass does not have a crystal structure. Okay, you can compare this with the manufacture of cement. What happens to cement? What happens to glass? See what is the difference when you are going through your material, not material, through your study. These are the basic materials which glass is made up of. You put all of this into a huge furnace. So this is a photograph of which I took from Google. So raw materials are being added into the furnace, and when you get the material out of the furnace, you can see the glass coming out and forming into a, like, you know, coming like a waterfall. And this sheet is the glass, so it's continuously kept on rolled out. Okay, so you can get glass of various types and thickness. Coming back here, these are the types of glass which we normally talk about. Okay, in heat treated glass, we got two types of heat treated glass. One is the tempered glass. Okay, whenever you want some desirable properties, you need to do some operations. One of the operations is heat treatment. Heat treatment is done for many of the things, including steel. Okay, for instance, for stress relieving, you use annealing. Annealing is a process of stress removal. Now, what is annealing? When you are having a thick plate of glass, you will find that the center is warmer than the outer parts. This causes the outer parts to cool and shrink. That is, they will be under compression, the inside is under tension. To avoid such a situation, what they do is they will bring the temperature slowly down. Okay. For instance, whenever you are having boilers and very heavy thick pressure vessels, after you do your welding operations also, what they do is they take them into huge ovens. Okay, they are all LPG fired. I mean, one of the things you use is LPG. One of the materials of firing is LPG. So you put it inside such a chamber and slowly bring down the temperature so that the outer wall and the inner wall do not have a differential temperature. So they cool to the at the same rate. Okay, so in glass also you have various things. You can do that to cool it uniformly, but in glass we do a slightly different thing. We purposely lock in stresses. We lock in what is known as thermal stresses. So stress is nothing but force per unit area, as you know. It's nothing but the inside is pulling and is trying to stretch. Outside surface is trying to compress. So this fight between the two means there is a stress inside. This is due to heat, so it's called as thermal stress. So we've got quite a few types. So first is tempered glass. Tempered as well as this heat strengthened glass, both of them are heat treated glasses. Now the amount to which you have the forces locked in is the difference. Now when you are having a tempered glass, where have you seen tempered glass? Have you seen tempered glass? Where? Huh? Mobile phone, yes. Mobile phone, you got tempered glass. Another thing is, if you see in your windshield, you will see tempered glass marked. Okay. At least in the old Ambassador cars, they used to have that mark, tempered glass. So what happens to tempered glass? Have you seen a bus accident or something? The moment the bus hits, the glass falls downward. It just falls downward. Okay, so this is the pattern with which it falls. The reason is, it's under so much of stress, whenever there is another impact, the way it shatters is into small pieces. This is also called a safety glass, so that we don't get hit by the flying sharp particles. Okay, on the other hand, if suppose you just have strengthened glass, you will find that it is breaking like this. Now let me just get my, yeah. So if you can, you see the pattern. This is the normal pattern which you see when you got your when you get your mirror broken, or some of the windows. Most of the windows, when they break, you will find that they have this jagged edges. You get a pattern which is jagged, right? So this is the difference between these two types of glasses. What is the difference? It is the amount of locked in stresses. For this, you are having 7500 psi, and here you are having about 10,000. So this is the only difference. The net pressure difference between the outer wall and inner. Outer is cooler, inner wall is hotter. When you let it cool fully, it still has a resultant stress. Okay, so this is called the heat strengthened. This is the difference between the heat strengthened and tempered glass. Now for your building application, which of these two will you prefer?
Huh?
Which one? Second one, tempered glass.
Heat strengthened.
Okay, the next question is why? To a large extent, I mean, like you are right. See, the thing is, the other glass will bend more than the tempered glass. Tempered glass cannot take even the slightest impact. Okay, so, but anyway, we go for the other types of glasses also. This laminated glass is another thing which is very common. Laminated is nothing but you are keeping it in layers. You'll have a plastic sheet in between. What happens is, like the glass which you told, even if it breaks, it will not fly easily. It will not be sharp pieces flying all over the place. Okay. Anybody wants to say anything more? Anyway, the next glass you are actually coming is your mobile phone glass. Okay. This Gorilla Glass was very common about 2 years ago. Everybody wanted to put Gorilla Glass. I don't know, now no phone seems to be marketing the Gorilla Glass. Okay, so what these people do is they use an ion exchange mechanism to get only the desirable properties of glass in their material. So the glass which they get is highly shatterproof. Okay, so they are using certain chemicals to get the desired property. Sometimes they may use when the glass is molten, they may use a salt bath or something else. Wherever they find they want the strength, they use it in that particular way. Okay. The next glass is a decorative glass called this fritted glass. Okay. So now you have a look at this pattern which is formed on the glass itself. This pattern is formed by putting some chemicals in a dry state and then they again pass it through the oven to get this pattern. Essentially, it's just a decorative glass. Then you got this reflective and tinted glass. What is this reflective and tinted glass? Yeah, three of you. The three of you, please, you can vacate the hall. See, I really know that all of you know what is here. Okay, this is not, I know it is not new. Okay, but suppose you feel it is not required, I don't see why you should waste your time here. Okay, now coming back here, we are coming to the float glass, which is by far one of the most common glass which is used in, which you get as panes. Okay, so most of your window panes and all these are made of glass. Okay, so it is just made by floating the piece of glass and you get it. For example, Saint Gobain float glass, you would have heard of that, right? Saint Gobain, at least I used to see quite a few of the TV ads. It is so clear, somebody comes and throws water, everybody thinks that it is falling on them. So this is the thing about float glass, or this was the reason why they brought about float glass itself. They wanted very good optical properties. Now, what do you mean by bad optical qualities? Have you seen light through a Nescafe bottle or some other coffee bottle or Horlicks bottle, for instance, glass bottle? How is the quality of light that passes through it? You have lot of things which is desirable. Maybe there is a prismatic effect where you get colors and then there is the clarity is not that much, but compare it to that Saint Gobain glass advertisement, you find that there is so much of difference. Okay, so this is why this float glass actually came to be. Okay, and it is also one of the glasses which are used a lot. Then we got some special glasses. So these have very special reflective properties. These glasses have very special reflective properties and we are quite interested in these glasses. So this large arrow indicates that light is coming from outside. A float glass will allow most of the light to pass through. Okay, and other thing is, if you are having a reflective glass, you'll find that most of the light goes out. Okay, and of course this is the double glazing. Now I'm going to show a clipping from the Burj Dubai video which we showed some time ago. Okay, you make the observations. Probably you can just turn off the fans so that you can hear better. Just 5 minutes, okay? Okay, so that was you can turn on the fans back on, please. Okay, now this is a example of the double glazed wall, which or section which we showed in the previous slide. Actually, what is happening, you could see they have two types of radiation coming in, ultraviolet and infrared. So you need to address both of them. And this is a very smart way this glass has been put to use. And also, can you think of the amount of pressure which would have been incident on that glass? They had an airplane propeller blowing wind onto the surface. And not only that, they also had, they were spraying water so that any gap in any of the sealant or anything will be immediately found out. Okay, so this is essentially a material. This is essentially a material, and we are interested to select the right kind of material for the particular application. See, there are two things to be thought of. This glass may not be very much required for something like your TT or SJT. For two reasons, the building is not going to be exposed to that much of wind forces, not to the level as to what this Bridge Dubai is going to be experiencing. So if you are going to use ordinary glass in Bridge Dubai, the force of the wind will be so much that it will just shatter into your face. Okay, that much pressure, the amount of the wind pressure which will be there at that height will be very great. Second thing is, of course, they needed also to reduce the radiation. Probably you can use a glass which is of similar nature here. But again, the cost of the building is going to be depending on the cost of the materials that you put into it. Okay, so there are some limitations which we have, although we have very good choice of materials. So anyway, these are some of the kinds of glasses which you get to see. Okay, mullion is a vertical member usually used to break the glass windows, panel sizes. So if suppose you are having sometimes, you know, long panels, okay, where you just see from one side to the other. So that is one example. Then hurricane resistant glazing, definitely that Burj Dubai glazing is hurricane resistant. Sometimes they suspend glass from cables for decorative purposes. It will be like a portico or something like what you have in airports. Then you got pressure resistant glazing. You will understand what a pressure resistant is. Radiation, you can choose what radiation your glass is going to prevent from entering. You saw in this, UV and IR rays were filtered. In the same way, you can filter any other frequency of light or radiation which you want. However, I'm not sure much sure about what it does to X-ray and stuff like that. Okay, but for the good part, most of the ordinary radiation you can definitely take care of. Then of course, security glazing is the glazing which you have for bulletproof and you know, like impact resistant and stuff like that. Because you'll find that in many cases, glass is much stronger than steel. Glass is very much stronger than steel itself. So under such circumstances, the choice of material, okay, choice of glass is almost infinite. Okay, now when we are going to look at glass per se, okay, think of glass as even works of art. Nowadays you see many painted glass windows. In olden days, especially in many of the churches, if you see, they got very intricate patterns made and they put glass into it. Okay, so that used to be one of the things which was much used. But of course, nowadays people don't spend that much money on decoration. However, glass is one of the, what shall I say, oldest materials and also one of the most energy efficient materials which can be designed. So what do we mean by energy efficient? You can reduce the heating and cooling loads, okay, or air conditioning loads can be very easily reduced. You can also reduce your lighting loads if you are going to use the window panels efficiently. Okay, for instance, have you heard of the Northlight truss? Northlight truss, in many of the industries, a sawtooth pattern roof is provided. So they keep the roof in such a manner that maximum sunlight will be always present in the inside the building. So suppose you have such a lighting system, you will find that during the day at least you can cut a lot of artificial lighting. Okay, so this is something which glass is very, very good in. Okay, now if you are going to be asked, like, what are the applications of glass? Does glass have any architectural application? Does glass have architectural application? Yes, glass has a lot of architectural application. Does it have structural application? In fact, glass can be used as structural members also. Then there are things called glass bricks. Okay, glass bricks. Bricks are made of glass. So all the properties of glass, whatever you want, they have. In addition to that, they are also going to make it decorative. In addition to that, they are also going to make it highly decorative. Okay, so I'm these are the references which I used. Of course, I was wanting to speak about ferro cement, but today I don't think it's possible, so I'm skipping ferro cement. But glass architecture, and if you look at this AGC solar, they've got the two high-res photographs of raw materials being fed into the furnace, and excuse me, glass coming out of the furnace were from that side. Then there is this, you can go to this 12 facts about heat treated glass. So all the merits, demerits of heat treated glass is available there. So for instance, the answers like when you can use heat treated glass will come to you if you are going to understand the principles which are outlined in this. Okay. So do you have any doubts in this passage or in about glass?